much of the reading chapter in particular is about problem solving. You just said there are different kinds of reading, and part of that chapter has barriers and obstacles, hurdles, and how to get over them. And the fourth chapter on sources really does kind of set that tone that now it's time to put your own voice in there. You have to hear what other people are saying first, and then you want to put your own voice in there. So sources these days are more difficult even. I mean, there's so much that students go to Google, they go to Wikipedia, but we really try to talk with them about how to use sources to enter that conversation, to become a member of a community with an informed opinion, not just a gut reaction, although gut reaction is a good place to start, but where they're looking for sources, they're evaluating their sources. We talked about plagiarism, whether a mashup is plagiarism and how that works and how plagiarism has perhaps gotten more complicated with the access, wide access and instant access to information. And then we talked about the nuts and bolts, back to the writing. How do you integrate sources? But all the time we're encouraging kids to have their own voice and to find a way to enter into that conversation. So the culminating activity for each of the four chapters has something to do with community. So they're talking about what a community to which they belong, a community where they have a particular role. And in this chapter on sources, they're asked to consider whether social media is a way to encourage or to discourage, to promote, or maybe to, in some ways, redefine community. So we're working on several levels in these opening chapters, even though they're foundational, but we're also trying to get them into topics so that they'll get interested in reading, writing, speaking, listening, all of those skills that we know are so important.
And so important at the beginning of the year. All of these skills are foundational, but you're also, through these activities, and especially through these culminating activities, a teacher is getting a sense of where their students are. Where are your
Exactly.
students in terms of their reading, writing, speaking, and synthesizing abilities? At the beginning of the year, getting that, plus building up your classroom community, you have a really good beginning to the year.
Right, and as Tracy already said, and I just to emphasize this a little bit more, those opening chapters have texts in them. There are lots of things that people can engage with, students and teachers can engage with, but they also could use summer reading. Those chapters are ways to try out what you did when you read for the summer, or perhaps a novel that the teacher wants to start the year with.